Hi friends, welcome to Exciting Art World. Today I am going to prepare a very crispy and crunchy thatai recipe. Before going to the channel, subscribe our channel. First of all, take 250 gram chana dal, rinse it and soak it in hot water for 30 minutes. After that, drain the chana dal, dry it like this in a cotton cloth for a half an hour. Take 100 grams of red chili and dry roast it. Let them become cool. Grind it in a mixer jar and transfer to the plate. Add some curry leaves. Grind it and transfer into the plate. Take 2 spoons of asafoetida.
If you want to add green chili, grind it and add it.
Add required salt. I'm adding 3 spoons of salt. Now add 5 spoons of roasted chana dal. I have 100 grams of sesame seeds. In that same kadai, add 2 kg rice flour. This is actually homemade rice flour. Keep it in a medium low flame. Roast it well. Roast rice flour till it becomes warm to touch. Remove it in a plate. In the same kadai, add 200 grams of dalda. Melt it for a while. We have the rice flour plate. I'm adding the curry leaves flakes, red chili flakes, roasted chana dal, asafoetida, sesame seeds and soaked chana dal. Roasted chana dal helps in making the thattai light and crispy. Mix it together.
This is actually a traditional recipe. We are preparing for our Diwali celebration.
Now I am adding the dalda into it. Mix it with a ladle. Wash the jar with water. Add into it. If you want to add butter, you can add.
Choice up to you.
Mix the spices and herbs with the flour. With your fingertips, mix the flour nicely. Addition of water will depend on the texture and quality of rice flour. If you want to add water, just sprinkle it. Gently mix and start bringing the mixture together. Knead to a smooth semi-soft dough. Make small balls from the dough. Take clean cotton napkin. Spread some oil on your fingers while flattening them. Press and flatten thattai with your fingertips to a thin round. Take a kadai, heat the oil. Lift the thattai gently one by one. Keep flame to medium or medium high while frying. Now it start bubbling. It means the oil is in correct temperature.
This recipe is one of my favorite.
When one side is crisp, then flip over each thattai. Fry the second side till it crisp. You can flip a couple of times for that even golden color and crispness. When the oil stops bubbling and sizzling, this means the thattai is fried and done. Remove the slotted ladle. Transfer it into the plate. Now the crispy thattai is ready to serve. If you like this video, like it, share it, comment it, subscribe it, click the bell icon. Without fail, catch you in next video. Keep watching our channel. Bye. Thank you.